You know, networks don't talk about it.
Big Doug.
Does your wife hate you because you're busted?
Government can't tax it.
Big Doug.
Did you blow the kids' college fund on bad picks?
But sports betting is a $200 billion a year business.
Big Doug.
Telephone turned off. Mortgage payments 2 months behind.
A lot of gamblers out there, man. And they have needs.
Big Doug.
Your car repossessed? Call Big Doug.
And come Monday morning after a losing weekend, they got big needs.
Big Doug.
Gargantuan.
Mully and Hanley, Chicago Sports Radio 6-7 of the Score. Big Doug joins us on the Home Run In Pizza Hotline. Visit HRIFamilyFun.com to save up to $34.95. He is a legend and a man that that I respect so much. I won't read records this week, Big Doug. I need the use of my right leg.
You finally learned your lesson, haven't you?
Yes, I have.
It's taken me a while to get to you, to understand you. You know, Mully, if you're not a hemorrhoid, get off my ass, all right?
Well, Brian is all puffy-chested. He wants to brag about his 24-15-1
record. I just said to Dustin, the hell with the machine that runs it 50,000 times.
Yeah.
Follow me.
He went 4-1 last week. You went the inverted 4-1. He's all bragging about it. I said, I'm not bringing it up.
No.
I need that right knee.
Anyone could be 24-15-1.
Exactly.
Against the
number. Brian, thank you for not annoying me more than you do.
It's early.
Brian, it's hard to believe you beat a million sperm. So anyway, let's go from here.
What have you heard? Yeah.
Abraham Lincoln said it. That's the ballot.
That reminds me, I gotta get my palms cut today.
That's right. The ballot is stronger than the bullet.
The ballot is stronger than the bullet.
There you go.
It's a regular statement. I mean, a true statement. Anyway, I'm in Chicago, and I'll probably vote 20, 30 times. I want to get back in there.
It's a great chance to catch up with all your dead relatives.
Absolutely. Yeah. You know, and politicians are wonderful people. As long as they stay away from things they don't understand, like working for a living. I mean nuts, these politicians.
They get election day off. Someone texted in that the state workers get election days off. Is that right?
True?
I don't know. Boy.
I don't know. I know I don't get a day off.
Never. This year, high season.
Well,
come on.
The difference between the government and the mafia is one of them is organized. That's the only damn thing that's different with the whole deal.
You know, Big Doug, I understand you probably said a book on the presidential election, but do you do some of the smaller races?
I do, yeah. I do some of the smaller races. I'm basically what it is. The ones I'm very good at are the ones that I fix, you know, and the ones that are all set to go. So
I was very intimidated when you were outside. You know, those guys about 50 feet from your polling place with the little palm cards telling you who to vote for or suggesting?
Yeah.
You do a little more than suggest.
Yeah. No, I don't.
Here's who you're voting for today, did you know?
Exactly. And that will work out that way, too. You know, Brian, I got to tell you this. I just got back from getting my flu shot.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I got my shingles shot. I got my pneumonia shot.
You got it all?
Yeah. No, I did. Not really. They wouldn't give me the Viagra shot.
No.
They said they didn't want to put a new flagpole on a condemned building. That's exactly what they told me.
Good Lord.
Well, I'll tell you what, that Jennifer's a card, boy. There's no question about it. But how you guys been? How's it going? Everything going fine? I mean, I just, I listen to your show every day. And you guys are terrific. Everything is, seems wonderful.
Well, we're still waiting for Mike Tice to learn the play calling. Jay told us it's going to take some time, but we're good.
Well, it always takes time. You just can't jump in there, you know. And maybe I'll talk to Mike a little bit. Because I went back on my whiskey diet. I lost 10 days this time. So anyway.
That's my favorite, whatever.
As Brian always says, sometimes too much to drink isn't enough.
That's
what Brian says.
That's it. Words to live by.
Let's get to it, shall we, Big Doug?
Let's go after him, little buddy.
All right, my pal. It's Alabama -9 at LSU. -9, Big Doug.
Well, you know what? I tell you, I read an interesting article about Alabama and talking about how the fundamentals, how Nick Saban takes these kids and puts them through all the fundamentals. That's my biggest fault, I think, in football is not teaching fundamentals. And he does it. He does it with the linemen. They teach them how to, how to bend their knees, how to move. For example, to keep the back. The backs, they keep that ball high and tight in the shoulder. You know, in 1,286 carries, Alabama, 1,000. 286 carries. They've only had five fumbles.
Oh, my.
They tackle every day. So I think that the right now the Alabama is just so strong. And last year they beat LSU, 21-0 in the bowl championship series title game. So I'm looking right now. Both these defenses are good. Don't get me wrong. Alabama's number one. I believe LSU's number two. Alabama has 14 interceptions. LSU has 13. I am going to go with Alabama.
Yeah, I'm with you. Bama not only allowing only 8.1 points per game, Big Doug, probably arguably the best offensive line in college. And when you look at LSU, you just wonder how they're going to score. How are they going to compete against
LSU has no passing game,
Brian. No. I think these guys, 7 touchdown passes, not good enough. I'll lay the points, and it might even go up higher than the 9 we're laying here, but I'll lay the 9.
Buckethead is playing from LaSalle as opposed to Peru, and he takes Alabama.
Oh, boy.
Uh-oh.
You're all a bunch of sheep.
Tiger
bait. I walk on the avenue. Never thought I'd meet a handicapper like you. Meet a handicapper like you. The kind of picks that make you sick. The kind of picks that taught me how to lose. Now I owe Big Doug. So I ran so far away.
Come here.
I just ran. I ran all night and day.
Come here, you.
I couldn't get away.
It's not my fault, you moron, that you use my picks. I'm not God. Hey, God.
Oh, you gotta love Big Doug.
That's the attitude right now.
Arizona travels to Cheeseland to take on the Green Bay Packers. The Packers favored by 11.
Hi, Arizona. I'll tell you, that team is, I think, in disarray. I don't know who's going to quarterback. Is Colt still out with his ribs? Skelton's going to play? They don't have much of a ground game. Their offensive line is terrible. Green Bay, though, on the other hand, they can't run the ball either. But again, too, they have one thing. Rodgers, 69% completion, 7.29 yards per attempt, 21 touchdowns and 4 interceptions. And by the way, you guys listening, he's been sacked 28 times too, boys. I don't want to hear that story anymore. 107.9 quarterback rating. I'm going to go with Green Bay.
I'm with you, Big Doug. Last week, I didn't like the fact that they were going to lay all the points against the Jaguars, and they didn't. They didn't cover. And, Arizona coming off of a Monday night game on the road, indoor team coming outdoors. I'll leave the points 11, 12, 13, 16. Who cares? They'll cover.
Buckethead goes the other way, takes Arizona. The Steelers are treating their game against the Giants like a trip to Wisconsin. You're in, you're out. Steelers at the Giants. No hotel room, so they're just going in for the game and leaving.
That's it.
Giants favored by 3 in the hook, Big Doug.
I like the Steelers, again, too. The Steelers are Roethlisberger. You know, they really come. They're digging and dunking. And this Todd Haley got a hold of Roethlisberger. And, the guy is like has 14 touchdowns and 3 interceptions. They do have some speed on the outside with Wallace and Brown. There's no question about that. But they're used at tight end quite a bit. Keith Miller has 6 touchdown catches. And they're strong. I mean, they're strong on third down conversion. The Giants, on the other hand, beat Dallas. They won at 23-0. They almost lost the damn game. But the Giants are the Giants. The fourth quarter belongs to Eli Manning. They've won 4 in a row. And myself personally, I think Tom Coughlin's the best NFL coach out there. But I'm looking at this football game with Manning with 12 touchdowns, 8 interceptions, and 81.1 quarterback rating. I am a homer. Not a homer, a homer. Homer.
Wow. I didn't expect
homer.
That revelation.
There's anything wrong with that.
Delete that, will you, Dustin, please? I'm taking the Steelers.
Huh?
Plus 3.5.
We're lockstep this week, Big Doug. I don't know if that's good or bad.
Yeah, you had a roll, buddy.
Yeah, Big Ben. He's playing as well. He's certainly as efficiently as any quarterback in the league at this point. And I don't know, the distraction of the hurricane for the players on the Giants a little bit might weigh into that. Maybe the team coming in and out the same day will be of a better mindset. I'll take the Steelers.
Just so you know, Big Doug, Brian said that 24-15-1, if he just picks your picks the rest of the year, he's guaranteed to win.
I didn't do that.
What'd you say that for, Brian?
Buckethead!
Brian, your body will look good in my trunk, pal.
It's a pretty good strategy if I thought of it.
Oh, yeah. Buckethead's going with the Giants.
Oh, my friends wonder why I call you all the time. What can I say? I just feel that I need to hit a 5-team parlay. You think maybe I need help? No, I know that I'm right. All right. I'm just better off not listening to Big Doug's advice. When Doug insists I pay my debt, I'll run and hide. When he wants to know when I'll pay, I only smile when I lie, then I run and hide. Because Doug's fist is on my lips. Because Doug's fist is on my lips. Because Doug's fist is on my lips. Now I can't kiss my wife. Because Doug's fist is on my lips. Because Doug's fist, I can't make miss. Because Doug's fist is on my lips. When he turns out my lights.
The Eagles are at the Saints, Big Doug. The Saints -3.
How to talk about getting rid of, Vic. Are they nuts? Reed's not going to change the quarterbacks right now. His job's on the line. I think his best chance of keeping his job is Vic. And Vic didn't have any turnovers last week. It was a decent game. But they have a whole problem there where they're switching their defensive coordinator and all that. But here's the point. I'm going to take the Eagles and I'm going to tell you why. This Saints defense is mush. There's no question about it. They gave up 530 yards last week. They're averaging giving up over 470 yards per game. So I don't see, even with Breeze as strong as he is, with his quarterback rating, 20 touchdowns, 8 interceptions, I'm taking the Eagles on this one.
Yeah, this is purely a contrarian pick. We're finally going to disagree here, Big Doug. Everyone likes the Eagles, and it's because of all the reasons you stated about, it's more a vote against the Saints than for the Eagles. But I'll take the Saints at home, laying the 3. They can't be as bad as they've shown, can they?
I don't know. Yes, they are. They're terrible.
Right. I shamed him into taking a pick other than yours, Big Doug. Buckethead is in LaSalle. And
the guy on the sidelines got a lot of thoughts.
Oh, I know. There's a reason I can just sit here and comment. The Eagles for Buckethead. Uh-oh.
I ran from a man. I was in pain once he found me. Big Doug hit me with a broom. It wasn't good, was Norwegian wood. He told me to pray, then Big Doug grabbed me by my hair. Then I looked down and saw I needed some new underwear. Whoops. I was wrapped in a rug, placed in a van for betting the line. Parlay, it didn't come through. Big Dougie said, you're better off dead. Doug told me to pay up in the morning and started to laugh. I knew that I couldn't and started to run away fast. And with my arms broke, my house Doug he owns, cause the over was blown. So I lit it on fire. His picks were no good. Damn Norwegian Doug.
Bears minus. Go ahead, Doug.
My kid came home the other day and he said the teacher asked me, is Big Doug really your father?
It is threatening, isn't it? I bet his grades improve.
Yeah.
The Bears are minus -3 in the hook at Tennessee, Big Doug.
We all know about the Bears. We know how good their defense is. We know we're talking about the fact they're coming back in the fourth quarter, Cutler playing in the fourth quarter. And I think he was hurt last week. I really do. I think, you know, he was more mobile than he showed. I think he was protecting those ribs. And they were coming off a Monday night game. Tennessee is terrible. I mean, Tennessee's defense is brutal. And I don't know, in this football game, I'm saying the Bears should make a statement, a tremendous statement, offensively. And they should go out there and just whip their ass. So I'm looking for the Bears to take Tennessee apart. I'm taking the Chicago Bears.
Yeah, I'm glad you mentioned Jay's ribs. No one's really talking about it. I thought the same thing. He stood in the pocket for a reason, couldn't really
They're go. Delicious.
Yeah, try them with some little slaw and beans. I'm with you. I'm laying the points with the Bears, and I'd like the over in that one, too. I don't know why. I just do.
And Buckethead is in LaSalle, and he's walking in lockstep with the two of you, which means the Bears are in trouble.
Enjoys making voodoo dolls of his deadbeat gambler regulars. Knows firsthand what it's like to take candy from a baby. Goes to craft shows in the suburbs. He's the most interesting bookie in the world.
I don't always gamble, but when I do, I win. So call me, you moron, at 555-5555.
Stay Dougie, my friends.